African people seem to be on the margins, the mass of African people on the margins. Talk is cheap, just keep on talking. So if you speak at any of course, travel all over the world, and again, I couldn't help but to notice that wherever I found black people throughout the world, not just here in the United States, they were on, for the most part, on the margin of society. But still, I like the way you cut your...
My father and another co-worker were there at the courthouse. It's very much like the courthouse in Atlanta. You go up the steps. And so they had a long line of people all down the street waiting to go in. But they were timid because of, you know, what the past had been. And I was in the line, and a fellow that I grew up with had been discharged from the Army before I was, and he said, I'm going to go with you. But he had already done it. While we were waiting to, my father was in on the steps of the courthouse, and the other man was down on the street. We were trying to console the people, say, be patient, it's going to be all right. And so a policeman came up with a thing and beat this other man all across the head. That was the most demeaning experience I've ever had.
You go to the doctor, and he says your child is deaf. That's the end of the story as far as the medical field is concerned. They have no clue what to tell you or where to tell you to go.
My child started in the Atlanta Speech School, and he's profoundly deaf. That really was not the appropriate program for him. It was a deaf adult that was a teacher at the Atlanta Speech School that said he's got to pick his vocabulary up or he's not going to make it.
When you get to where you can't communicate with your child in any way, you're desperate to do something. And we put him in speech school. That's where they send you, to speech school. Teach him to talk and lip read, and he'll be just like you. Isn't that the biggest lie you ever heard? It is. Because that's not at all the way it is.